The rocket's recent success owes much to their pioneering decision to start crunching data about every aspect of their game. And this is the man responsible.
Analytics has really permeated everything. Our edge has allowed us to win the most games, 65 last year.
Computer scientist Daryl Morey is the sport's foremost data and statistics guru among NBA bosses.
You can break winning down into two things. One is, how many points do you get per possession? And then, how do you get extra possessions?
10 years ago, Daryl set out to find that winning formula. The Rockets were one of four NBA teams to install a pioneering video tracking system which mined raw data from games. What they discovered changed the way teams try to win. The data revealed which shots provided the best bang for buck, two-point dunks, and three-pointers, shot from outside the three-point line, rather than long-range two-point shots from inside it.
It's pretty dramatic how powerful the three-point shot is. You only have to make a third of your three-point shots to be worth a half of your two. Even within that, there's an extra miss. You might rebound offensively.
Let's face up, pulls the trigger, buries it.
In the 1990s, long two-point shots from just inside the three-point line were common. But Daryl's analysis showed that statistically, these shots provided the worst return. The number of attempted three-point shots has increased every year for the past decade. In the 2017-18 season, the Rockets made more three-pointers than any other team in NBA history. And this was a major reason they won more games than any of their rivals.
Every percentage matters in sports, and extracting those percentages is what's really become much easier with data. We're in a pretty big transformational stage in sport.
Professor Rajiv Maheshwaran co-founded Second Spectrum. The analytics company gathers and codes a vast range of increasingly granular data for all 30 NBA teams.
Right, it feels like 2D chess pieces.
Cameras now track and record 3D spatial data for every player and ball movement at 25 frames per second. Machine learning technology uses this huge volume of data to produce interactive visualizations, allowing teams to analyze the minutiae of their performances and achieve marginal gains on court.
At first, we taught the machine about 20 terms. Right now, it knows over 500 basketball terms. So the machine is essentially the integrated knowledge of all the elite basketball coaches.
There is a particular focus on all important data around player movement and the probability of making a shot.
What we can do with the machine is to say, look at all the shots like this one and tell me the chance that this shot really could go in either for this player or for an average player. And you bring in all the things that a person can see, not just where they're standing, but how they're moving, what type of a shot they're trying to take, where are the defenders. And what we can do is we can put a number to what previously was a feeling or something qualitative.
Data analysis has even changed the type of players that successful teams like the Rockets have. Players today are, on average, leaner and more agile.
Having skilled players, even if they're a little smaller, is more important than having bigger guys who are less skilled.
When it comes to recruiting new players from the college draft each season, poring over data on player performance has given the Rockets a winning edge.
We've been able to eke out about a 5% edge, and that actually turns out to be a massive advantage.
Pro basketball's finale for the NBA title.
Basketball has constantly changed, but it's about to enter a brave new world, where data could be courtside in the hands of coaches, helping to swing a game as it happens.
The data is always getting faster and faster. The data used to take hours. We've got it down to minutes, and very soon it'll be down to seconds. It's basically going to become
functionally real-time very, very soon. I don't think we've scratched the surface of what's possible with data.
Sports fans around the globe are passionate about their favourite teams. And fans of Manchester City Football Club in particular have plenty to cheer about. Like two league championships in the last half a dozen years and a squad well known for its high-pressure, possession-based style of play. Forbes estimates that Manchester City, one of the 20 teams that make up the UK's fabled Premier League, is the fifth most valuable football club in the entire world. Numbers don't lie. And these days, statistics play a big role in the fan experience. Manchester City uses the SAP Analytics Cloud solution to access and analyze up to 10 years' worth of data about the team and its players. With this insight, the football club can evaluate trends over time, make direct player-to-player comparisons, and create great content that it then shares with millions of fans through its website and social channels. And Manchester City's social reach is impressive. Statistics are part of the matchday experience too. The team's award-winning City Pulse wall is a dramatic digital display and touchscreen located right in the stadium complex. This interactive attraction, which is powered by the SAP HANA database, lets the fans themselves access and analyze real-time player statistics while attending the game. Statistics provide fans an even deeper understanding of the team's performance on the pitch. It's all part of Manchester City's priority in finding innovative and meaningful ways to connect with its loyal and global fan base.
On that stops the feet dislocating or turning. Oh.
Push up underneath it. Come on, Luzerski.
Yeah. He's got it in, but it's an easy serve, and that's easy.
He is 11 centimetres tall, and he's involved again.
Starting to squeeze Russia. Wrong spot.
Jovovic. Massive block.
Recovery here for Bulgaria. Great blocking. That's fantastic stuff. We'll see. Arrived there.
Seven set points. Gapet drills that inside the line for an ace.
Impressive numbers from Gapet. Stitch back on. Oh, is that a clean ace? Yes, it is. Now he's showboating. Gapet then continues to serve. Wow, what a beast of a serve that was. And that step round nicely. Still. Oh, clean ace. Unstoppable. It's an ace serve for Engapet and a point for France.
Dealt with.